So we think there's a link between ex-professional football players and neurodegeneration. For example, a recent study in Scotland demonstrated a threefold increase in dementia in ex-professional football players compared with the average population.
Played football for 20 years professionally. Headed many balls over that period. Scored plenty of goals with my head.
It's Notman's cross, it's Roberts!
And I just want to see, is there anything I should be concerned about in the foreseeable future? I think it's always important to improve and make things better. The game has improved, balls are lighter, but still, you know, the modern day player will still be at risk of this type of illness, and if we can help improve that and sort of keep it away, and especially with young children, we don't know how they cope with heading the ball. Me personally, I think that should be banned from a certain age, and the research and all the work and the testing that they're doing here will help everybody.
So there really are things people watching can do. First of all, if you're an ex-professional football player, we would love to recruit you to the study. Second, if you're an active older adult, haven't been exposed to pro football or rugby, then you can participate as well. And finally, if you're just interested in the study, we've started a Just Giving campaign to help us fund the project going forward. A small group of people will actually be coming into the lab and doing some of our physical tests, but by and large, the vast majority of people in the study will actually be doing it from the comfort of their own homes. So what we'll do is have them log into a website and do a series of attention tests, some memory tests, some cognitive function, and some spatial navigation tests that can all be done in less than 20 minutes.